What is science truly? Marie Curie said, science is measurement, measurement is science. If that were so, you can't think. Can you think? Can you measure your thinking? No, no. So unscientific. Thinking is unscientific. You love your boyfriend or a girlfriend. Can you measure love? Unscientific. So what cannot be measured is unscientific. So science dies a natural death when measurement. This world cannot be measured by science. That's why we only know 5% of the world. Nuclear energy, gravitational energy, and electromagnetic energy, because they can be measured. 95% of the occult energy cannot be measured, but that's the most powerful energy. I will very soon tell you what you can do with occult energy. We'll come back to that. So, it became a science overnight, and by the wrong route, and this science has no meaning. So, they refined the diagnosis science. They came changed. John von Neumann, a Hungarian chemist, Hungarian-born ethnic chemist, American Nobel laureate, who said, I quote, science is making models. Mark my words. Science is making models, comma, which are mathematical constructs, semicolon, which with verbal jargon are supposed to work, full stop. Okay, keep the definition. Now, modern medicine, so-called scientific medicine, we say, has a scientific base of linear mathematics. Or reductionist science, which is not a holistic science. Now, human body is not linear at all. It's a dynamic, holistic system. Now, if you measure the human body linearly, what will happen? I'll give you an example. When you go to a cardiologist, he will check you and say, oh, your ejection fraction is only 40%. So, you're worried. That fear kills you. Mind you, you will soon die. But what is he right? What is he doing? He is using a linear mathematical model. Science is making models, right? Mathematical model. What's the really mathematical model? What is the amount of blood pumped out with each contraction of the heart? Okay? That's called ejection fraction. So, he is using this linear measurement into a non-linear structure, heart. Linear mathematics is Euclidean. So, Euclidean mathematics works on Euclidean structures only. It must be either a square globe, triangle, square or oblong. Heart is neither of these, none of these. Heart cannot be. Heart actually is a non-linear structure which requires a different mathematical model which we can't understand. That's called non-linear mathematics, which in the West is called Mandelbrot's mathematics and in the East is called Vedic mathematics. Very difficult, very, very difficult. Mandelbrot alone understood it. And that's how Mandelbrot constructed the computers on the basis of binary numbers. So, non-linear mathematics is used in, linear mathematics is used in a non-linear structure. So, the ejection fraction is absolutely wrong. Sometimes we get patients with an ejection fraction of 25. He has gone to Ayyappa temple 3 times. You know where it is? It's almost like the Himalayas. I simply believe in what the patient says. I ask him, can you go up to the first floor without any trouble? Second floor? Trouble? Third floor? Yes. Then your ejection fraction is probably more than normal. Here is a patient with an ejection fraction of 40% from the doctor. He can't go to the toilet without having chest pain and breathlessness. That is because we are marrying linear mathematics to a non-linear structure. It's not only an intercaste marriage, it's now a marriage which has to be divorced very soon. The sooner we do, the better. So, ladies and gentlemen, I have told you, if not enough to say, that the Western scientific base of medicine is all wrong. Now, I have been saying this for a long time. I am very happy last year, the chairman of the NICE, NICE is the biggest organization in England. That is, the NICE is the organization which controls clinical excellence. National Institute of Clinical Excellence. Sir Michael Rawlins is the president. And Sir Rawlins was giving a talk at the Royal College, what's called the appointed lectures, the named lectures. And he said, I quote, unfortunately, we have been giving RCTs and keeping them at a high pedestal, saying that they're a scientific thing, is not deserved. RCTs do not deserve to be the pedestal at which they're kept, which means all our studies, which you and I believe in practice also, are not true. Is it clear now? Which means the Western scientific medicine is not really scientific, if you want to know. But based on this, the class system started. Western medicine is scientific. All other things, not scientific. One day I was giving a lecture in IIT Bombay. And they had invited me to give a lecture on blood pressure. IIT, you know, IIT is all supposed to be very brilliant boys and girls and brilliant professors. So lecture went on. So I told them, what is blood pressure? A physics teacher in the class, PUC class, tells the student, laminar flow cannot exert lateral pressure because if it does, then it can't flow cosine 90, 0. Right? Yeah. Mucks up, mucks up, mucks up. Passes a CET with very high rank. Gets into the medical school. Physiology professor comes, class. Lateral pressure exerted by the flowing blood is called lateral blood pressure. That's blood pressure. Lateral pressure exerted by the flowing blood on the vessel wall is called blood pressure. I said, what is this? Where do these two things go? Second thing is, does the blood flow laminarly inside the blood vessel? Suppose you give an obstruction of the blood pressure, we say, oh, it's very bad obstruction. Have you heard of the Bernoulli effect? As a matter of fact, the blood flow may be better with a little obstruction. I was telling Karthikeyan Saab that the obstruction to the coronary arteries. See, with the simple three things we didn't ask ourselves. Why don't animals get a heart attack? Why only man should get a heart attack? Have you ever thought about it? Number two, coronary arteries fill in diastole, not in systole. So the pressure head is so low that why should coronary arteries have atherosclerosis? I can understand the carotid arteries, leg arteries having, because the pressure is high, systemic pressure. Here diastolic pressure. So if you ask these three questions, it will be very clear to you that atherosclerosis is not a disease at all. Atherosclerosis is a good thing that the body does to band-aid an injury to your vessel wall. It's a beautiful band-aid. Actually, Valentin Fuster, a very famous cardiologist, interventional cardiologist in Washington, has written, I quote, he said, less than 30% of the infarct-related coronary arteries are more than 50% blocked. Did you understand that? Less than 30% of the infarct-related vessel means the vessel which supplies the heart attack area, which is a block, are less than 50% blocked. So bigger block is not important, lesser block is important. And if you go deep into it, you find out animals do not get a heart attack because animals can produce vitamin C in their system. You and I get a heart attack because we don't have capacity to produce vitamin C. So heart attack possibly is a younger brother of scurvy. You heard scurvy, you bleed everywhere. Here you bleed into the vessel wall and then the vessel wall gets blocked and then heart attack comes. I mean, we don't think. Every newborn child, wrote Alexis Carrel, a Nobel laureate surgeon who taught surgeons how to stitch blood vessels. He wrote, every newborn child is a genius, only to be converted into an idiot in school. Because he stopped thinking. Otherwise, a student who is supposed to be a good student, quote-unquote, who gets highest mark is called a good student, no? Is the best mugger. Who has said cosine 90 is zero, how can he accept the physiology professor saying that cosine 90 is the cause? Then one professor of, physics got up during question hour. He said, you're a brilliant lecture. I too don't believe in this blood pressure and all. I don't take medicines for that. But you mentioned Ayurveda. That's scientific, then you are a quack. I don't want to listen to you. This is the attitude of a professor in the IIT of physics. So I told him, sir, I'm so sorry, you are a professor in IIT. He didn't like that. He was very angry. I told him, I thought professors in IIT are wise people. You are a knowledgeable man in your subject, but you have no wisdom. Because you don't know what Ayurveda is. And you're talking about a thing you don't know. And Ayurveda probably has got the strongest scientific base because it depends on non-linear mathematics.